How's it going, Teal Boys? It is week 3, and this time around, we get to try to get revenge as we face off against number 12 NC State. They're 1-0 right now, but they're a B-plus team, a lower B-plus than us. We're 90 overall. I guess that means they must be an 89. We've got the better offense. They have the better defense, but I don't know if I'm too worried about that. We've played against some tremendous defenses so far. They did create 3 turnovers in their first game as they beat ECU, but it's ECU. We definitely have a harder schedule to this point, playing Notre Dame and Pitt. Notre Dame, I think, was ranked when we played them. We knocked them out. Both teams now 0-1 because they've only played us, and we won them both. Pretty solid wins for us. Both games, the final score looks a little bit closer than the game really felt. This is going to be probably our toughest test so far. NC State slaughtered us to open up the season last time out, so we're just going to hope that we can get our revenge and jump up a little bit further in the rankings. Not a whole lot of ranked games this week. We will see number 7 Washington playing number 9 USC. Is that it? We've got number 19 South Carolina and number 17 Georgia playing each other. So not a crazy amount of ranked matchups this week. The early season Heisman watch hasn't changed all that much. Bijan Robinson, still don't know if I'm saying that name correctly, but he's still leading the way with Spencer Rattler from Oklahoma in second, and the Oklahoma running back Marcus Major in third. Georgia has their running back Kendall Milton in fourth, and then, keeping with the theme, another running back, this time from Ohio State, Marcus Crowley, is in that final spot. I don't think that our running backs are going to make it up there this season, but I think with a complete enough team, we won't need a Heisman-winning player to get us where we want to go. Let's see if we can maybe find one. Going to recruiting, I have taken off a bunch of players that we just didn't stand a chance getting. It freed up a few points, but it also means that we have 7 new players to scout, a couple of tight ends, some a defensive end or two. And then we look, middle linebacker, corner, athlete. Let's see. What do we find? I'm looking for a tight end to replace our boy Derek Malden next season. Barrett Powell's a 79 overall. That's not too shabby. How about Derek Jones? He stays at a 76. I would be happy with either of them. Now we've got Ronnie and Willie, the defensive end combo. Ronnie Morgan stays at 75, and Willie Ralph goes up from a 75 to a 78. Again, both of those I would be completely fine with. Willie has some great block-shedding capabilities. How about this middle linebacker, Chris Poland? He goes up 4 overall to a 78. He looks pretty solid. That's some serious speed for a linebacker. 85 speed, 84 acceleration. He's got the 82 strength. He can tackle. Decent play rec, decent block-shedding, decent coverage. I mean, this guy seems like a pretty complete package. Maybe the guy that we pick up to help us replace Shelton when he leaves. Mason, I think, is in his senior season. Anthony Matthews, this corner, goes up to a 73. And I've added Andre Atkins because he's like the fastest player in this class. 98 speed, 95 acceleration for the athlete. I don't think there's much of a chance that we could pick him up, but I would love it. He's got great coverage as well. 85 man, 88 zone. This guy would make a great player in the secondary, and I think he could make a great running back as well. So if we have the chance to pick him up, you better believe that we will. And now let's start to see what we have in terms of players that we're in the lead with. You know, are the guys that we're wanting to pick up. We have the lead with Kevin West. He's a 68 overall linebacker. It's not the best that we've seen, so I'm not going to offer him a scholarship yet, although likely we will. Joe Rogers, this kicker, we know he's great. 85 overall, number one kicker in the country from Orangeburg, South Carolina. He's a local kid. We want him. He's probably going to be able to come. Antonio McBride, this defensive tackle, 77 overall, definitely worth a scholarship. And we can take some points away from him, still gaining 65 a week on North Carolina. So we'll drop Antonio down to 500. That's what we'll give him. How about Brockhampton? Losing 35 a week to Clemson. So the 50 that we took from Antonio, we'll give there. And is he good? He's 69 overall. We'll offer him the scholarship. Why not? Get it out of the way early. Matt Brigham, 69 overall defensive tackle. We're in the lead, but losing 30 a week to South Carolina. Again, not the best in the world, but we'll give him some points and a scholarship just because he could be pretty useful a couple years down the line, and I'd be stupid to go in against that. And now we're getting to guys that we have deficits with, and this is going to be such a difficult decision. Mike Shelby, this great corner. We are losing 55 a week to USC. We could potentially hold on for the entire season and get him in the offseason. 80 overall, 92 speed, 90 acceleration, 89 man, 88 zone. I think it's worth it. It is 700 points. If things start to change and it seems like it's bad news for us, then that's fine. But championship contender and conference prestige, his second bonus factors, those could change. Championship contender as a B+ now, we could definitely get that into the A's. That's free points for us. And our conference prestige, I mean, if we start doing really well, that could help. And if the Pac-12 starts doing worse, then that could help as well. So definitely not going to give up there. We've got Billy Gray, who we're losing 35 weeks, so we'll give him 50. Aaron Jenkins, we're gaining 160 towards Northwestern, and I'm going to take 100 away from him and hope that that continues. Logan Smith, we're losing 30, so now he gets 50 more. We're just trying to make it so that we're gaining towards teams, but it's not like ridiculous. And we don't want to be falling behind a ridiculous amount either. Let's give Michael Brigham 50 points. Kyle Edwards is another guy similar to our Mike Shelby. Mike Shelby's losing 55. Kyle Edwards losing 50. South Carolina is who we're up against. Conference prestige is his biggest thing, and South Carolina has a big benefit being in the SEC there. Proximity to home. We are about the same distance, so we both should be getting a B-, and our championship contender, again, can go up, and we might be able to jump up in front of South Carolina soon. I think they're like number 19 in the country. So again, losing points every week, but we could stay in the battle. And if we need to, we could always unlock him. So just chances for us to be able to pick up these guys is what we're looking for. And it's looking solid all around the board so far. So that'll do our scouting so far. I do want to check. No, we can't see if anybody's gotten an insta commit. But again, conference prestige is a big one. ACC's actually in... that's a weird way. We're tied with the SEC on average rank, but they get the benefit of the doubt, so they get the A, we get the A-. Again, if we win this game, it could be enough for the ACC to jump up, and if South Carolina loses a game, so, you know, we could be changing how we're getting points just like that, and, you know, maybe we jump the Pac-12 at some point this season. Kind of doubt that. B+ on the championship contender. Again, if we continue to win, that number should continue to improve for us. And those are like really the two biggest things with a lot of the recruits that we're looking at. So we've got our chances to pick up some serious players this year. Well, let's go ahead and get into this one. Heading just up north to play NC State. Yeah, 88 overall. They had a ridiculous running back, 99 overall, in Zonovan Knight last year. He must be gone along with a lot of other offensive production because their offense drops to an 84 overall. So the way our defense has played so far this season, I expect big things for us. We had a great game in the all-white jerseys or uniforms, so we're going to try to continue to use those until they fail. You know, use a little superstition there. And NC State has a lot of cool options. I'm debating, do we go all black or all red? We're going to let them wear all black. Black versus white in this game. And we'll see if we can take on the Wolfpack. A win here could be massive for us in picking up recruits and also just starting our campaign to get into the 18 playoff. These early season numbers don't mean a whole lot, but we're looking, you know, okay on offense, very mediocre on defense. We're not giving up a whole lot of yards, and we're giving up almost no rushing yards. Meanwhile, these guys are just, yeah, middle of the road on both sides, but again, their only game is against ECU, so just not the best competition. Best players for them, a little bit similar to ours. They go 92, 92, 92 across the board with a defensive tackle, a left guard, and a cornerback. Meanwhile, of course, we've got Grayson Bedgood and Rashad Chaney Jr. So, I mean, this is, it feels like a pretty even matchup, but I just feel like the edge leans towards us. So we've arrived now at Carter Finley Stadium. Decent chunk of fans have made the trip for this game as we'll go tails for the second game in a row. And for the second game in a row, tails fails, which means we're going to be starting with the football. 14 mile an hour wind today, but it looks like it's crosswind, thankfully. Once again, I forgot to make the depth chart changes out of game, so Deion Fountain returning the opening kickoff. Bit of a shame. The blocking, not great. Didn't need to do that spin move. We're still getting great blocking. There is a flag down, so, well, we got to midfield. I expect our drive to be starting somewhere around the 20, maybe inside it. There's a holding on Aaron Bedgood, and we're starting at our own 9. Oh, that's rough. So right out of the gates, we have a long drive in front of us, 91 yards to the goal line on the other side of the field. And CJ Beasley only picked up 2. That's not going to get it done if we average 2 a play. Try to continue to avoid throwing interceptions this season, but definitely wanting to pass. Although, why pass when you can run? Grayson gets 15 yards and starts to get us out of trouble. Kind of to where we should have started our drive. On this first down, we'll bring Jackson in motion and hand it off up the middle, and CJ Beasley can get that small little chunk of yards. And we'll hand it off to the running back again on 2nd and 7, and I just want to get the offensive line starting to move, start to tire out their defensive line, and so far it's working okay. On this 3rd and 5, Bedgood will come in motion, will step back to pass, and Bedgood over the middle. Ooh. Held onto it through the contact. That was a little bit closer of a throw than I wanted, but it works out. Let's go ahead and continue to try to run this ball. The more it works early, the better it'll work at the end of the game, and that's fantastic. CJ Beasley picks up 8 yards on his 4th carry. See what we can do on this one. 2nd and 2, we'll go play action, and I don't see anything but a chance to scramble as Grayson picked up the first down. I thought I was going to juke that guy out a little bit more, but it was enough for the first down, and we got positive yards, so I can't complain. Let's give it to Marquise Jackson on the jet sweep this time. 1st and 10, looking for the blocks. He got enough for positive yards. Hey, I'll take 6 yards on a sweep every single time. Again, the defense for NC State supposed to be the better unit this time around. Brayden Bennett on his first carry took a shot, lost a couple of yards, and I guess they knew what I was going to say, and they immediately came out to prove me wrong before I could say it. So 3rd and 6, stepping back to pass, we'll throw the timing route. Tyson Mobley holds onto that one through the contact, and the drive will continue to stay alive. Last time we ran this play, it didn't work out all that well. The spider 2Y banana. We found Logan Malden. Oh, that was a scary throw, but it works for 18 yards. I think a slightly better defensive back there, and that one was intercepted, but we're still alive. We're inside the red zone, and we're losing some yards with CJ Beasley on the halfback misdirection. Don't like it when they stop us on the run, so we're going to try to get them right back. A dive on this 2nd down, and we got our yards that we lost and a bunch more. Gives us a 3rd down, but it's 3rd and manageable. And at this point, I'm going to call this 4 down territory. We'll step back to pass. We've got Beasley inside the 5. I think he's down at the 1. Beautiful 1st and goal, and that play worked to perfection. See if they dial up the efforts to stop us from running. We'll go up the middle on this 1st and goal, and Brayden Bennett not able to get anything done. It's now 2nd and goal from the 1. This could be a massive goal line stand if they stop us, because I'm going to be incredibly stubborn here. Try the fullback dive with JJ Barr, and he doesn't have it either, although he got us inches away from getting in. And we'll try to run again here, this time a little bit towards the edge, giving it to Beasley as McDonald comes in motion. And Grayson actually kept it because the play got broken. We lost 3 yards, so the handoff isn't completed. It's 4th and goal from the 3.5, maybe the 4-yard line. Well, this is a risky play. We've taken almost the entire 1st quarter on this drive. Oh my gosh. In fact, we have taken the entire 1st quarter on this drive, as we're going to go for it on 4th and goal. And CJ Beasley couldn't get in. Oh, inches shy. So we spent an entire quarter to do nothing except move the ball 98 yards down the field and give it right to the Wolfpack of NC State. Defense has a great chance to get a safety, but if you know how we play, we're likely not getting that safety. Expect to see a big gain here is, yep, literally every single time without fail that I have somebody backed up against the goal line in this game, they break off a big run. This time, it's a 99-yard touchdown. I don't understand what it is in this game. We come out blitzing 11 players, and they don't have a problem. They got a gap the size of a gosh darn truck. Why do we even try? Well, that is infuriating. I legitimately don't know how we can get a safety with this team. But the offense gets to come back out, and who knows, maybe their defense will be so tired by the end of the game that they won't be able to walk, because that's the only hope that we have right now. That play's got me tilted, so hopefully we don't make a mistake on offense now, as I'm looking to pass, but it's not there, and we're just going to get Grayson out of bounds. The running game's working, it's just unable to get in the end zone so far. Well, we're going to try the flea flicker. See if we can get them with the trick play. The safety seems a little bit confused about what's going on. And, well, Grayson just got sacked for a loss of 5. That play did not work when they brought that much pressure. All right, let's keep passing. They're going to continue to bring pressure. I'm going to continue to roll outside the pocket. And we've got ourselves a 3rd and long to contend with. Oh, I'm not happy right now. My big hope on this one is that Jackson can just burn his man. We're going to give it a try. Oh, gosh, that one was underthrown by a mile. That's the 2nd time this has happened in 3 games, where we send Marquise Jackson deep, and they play him very deep, but then the ball is underthrown, and he's able to get it. So, I don't know, big play, but I don't like the way it's happening. 8 first downs to their 0, yet we're losing the game. A little bit disappointing. We do have more total yards now than them, as CJ Beasley fumbles the ball. Wow. Speechless, really, after that one. Clear fumble. Not getting that one overturned. And let's see. Can NC State run 2 plays for 14 points? All righty. What can the defense do? They were atrocious the first time out. This time it's a run, and the safety blitz gets there. Diggs, of all people, holds up the running back and prevents any gain. In fact, a loss of 2. If these guys wanted to get some turnovers, that would be great. We have essentially 2 with the turnover on downs. No. Ted Lilly is a god-tier running back, apparently. 3 carries for 119 yards. All right. Well, I guess we're blitzing every single play until they stop running it to him, because we can't do anything. We legitimately can't do anything. This is absurd. This is actually absurd. I'm not sure what else we can do differently. If they hand the ball off and he gets more than 10 yards here, I'm not sure I make it through this game. Oh my gosh. The fact that he's still got 2 yards is absurd. Oh, I'm raging right now. 2nd and 8. They're going to go with the option. Pitch gets out. Blocking is great. He breaks a tackle. He breaks another tackle, and he's got another 10 yards. All right, it's time for them to beat us through the air. I don't give a crap. If they pass for a touchdown here, I cannot allow them to run like this against us. So they go play action. We force the strip sack, and of course, we're not able to recover it. Anytime we have a chance at a turnover, it doesn't happen. We do drop them for a loss of 8, but come on, we got to recover these. Maybe now on 2nd and 18, we'll see them pass the ball, and the secondary can be tested for the first time. Backup running back is in. They do hand the ball off. Is the backup is good? Yeah. And the blocking is phenomenal. This is not the offense, or an 84 overall offense that we're playing against. There's actually like 0 chance that this offense is 84 overall. Quarterback scrambling, has a man short. We do hold them to a field goal attempt here. We need a miracle for them to miss this and us to still be in this game. Who knows? Maybe their kicker will be atrocious. It's a pretty long one. So will they be able to get it with the crosswind? No, he missed it. Pretty wide. It's returnable for Jackson. I didn't think he was going to be able to get to that one. Jackson's gone. A kick 6. Oh my gosh. What a way to turn things around. They never even had a chance to catch him. I haven't been holding the sprint button for half of that return. So Marquise Jackson ties this up. 2 massive plays in this game for touchdowns. And with 2 minutes left in the half, we're going to hope to hold them. Broken record there. Longest fumble return. That's what the game considers a fielded field goal. And with this extra point, we'll be able to tie the game up. So, not the way I expected this first half to go, that's for sure. Now the question is, does the defense have it in them to get another stop? And maybe can we get them into field goal range? If they want to miss another one short, I'd be more than happy to let Marquise give it another go at the return. All three timeouts, but only 2 minutes to play in the half. I expect them to be passing plenty on this one, and I'm fine with plays like that. I don't like that he got out of bounds. I wish the first sack would work, but it's better than giving up a 40-yard run. We'll see if we can get some pressure here, bringing a small blitz on second and six. They'll step back to pass and over the middle. It's all too easy as they go to the running back. This dude, literally, if he touches the ball, they get a first down. I don't know if I've ever seen something so insane in my life. This time they're going to go with the draw to him. Oh my gosh, we had a chance to really stop him and he still got 2 yards. Going to continue to bring the pressure. It's the only thing I think that can work to slow this offense down as they go over the middle, and it's 3rd and inches. Not likely for us to pick this one up. They take their first time out. We're bringing a massive blitz on 3rd and inches. It's a screen. Stokes has his tackle broken. Diggs pulls Keon Lassane down, but they pick up 20 more yards. This is not good. I've never seen a more efficient offense in this game. Quarterback is 5 for 5, passing phenomenally well, and yep, now 6 for 6, and their running game is impeccable. NC State has taken their 2nd timeout now. And if they're going to score a touchdown, we need to be able to answer back. And my coverage needs to be a little bit better. 1st and goal. Can we get the stop? It's not looking likely. Kind of expecting this to be a run. I'm going to try to stop it up the middle. They won't hand it off. Somebody's got to be open. There it is. 1 yard touchdown reception. And NC State apparently is this team's kryptonite. So with 49 seconds and all of our timeouts, what can we do? Jackson will be returning this ball. I need Bedgood not to commit a penalty early on here. And can we get the edge? Well, it was a waste of time, really, just for an extra 5 yards on the return. Let's let him run on 1st and 10. See if somebody can beat their man. And maybe if Grayson can, yeah, have some accurate passes. There's Deion Fountain for 25 yards. We're going to go right back at him. Forverts cheese time, 40 seconds left in the half. Outside the pocket, A is open, Y is open. We're going to scramble, though. I don't know. I don't trust making that throw, and we're going to take our first timeout. A touchdown is so crucial on this drive since they get the ball to start the 3rd quarter. So hoping for the best there as I'm looking Jackson back of the end zone potentially. No, they played the coverage well. It's bobbing around all over the place, and finally hits the ground. 28 seconds now. Believe it or not, that was Grayson's first incompletion of the game, as I'm going to throw a pick there. Okay, 2 turnovers in this game, and we are in too big of a hole to come out of right now. The way the offense is playing and the way the defense can't do anything to stop these guys right now, I don't see how we're going to get back into it. Our only hope at this point is literally for them to get to about 50 yards out or 45 yards out, and then for them to attempt a field goal so that we can field it and try to get another kick six. Otherwise, I'm worried it just won't be enough. 2nd and 6 here. What do we got? They're going to step back to pass. Quarterback takes a sack. I'm going to take the timeout. 3rd and 14. Who knows? Something might happen. Just hope that they don't hand this one off and let it go to the half, and they'll do just that. I'm going to throw for some content here. Oh, no, he got the stiff arm cheese. They're getting the field goal. He got the stiff arm cheese. If we just tackle him straight out of bounds, we got a great chance to return that. But, of course, nothing's going to go our way. And, well, they're going to score 3 points and then get the ball. Who knows? Maybe the kicker really can't hit it here. I doubt it, but I can hope for the best, I guess. And, well, at the very least, he's pushed it. Oh, my gosh, it's returnable. Jackson has the ball. He can't outrun the guy on the corner. How? He's got 97 speed. What does that guy have? Oh, our biggest chance to tie the game. Literally the only thing we have going for us in this first half is the field goal return. But yeah, we're down 14-7. We're opening up this 3rd quarter with an onside kick for sure, as the offense has been atrocious. An interception and a fumble. As well as the defense giving up a 99-yard touchdown run on NC State's first touch of the game. Just not going to get it done. Let's see if anything good can happen for us. Frederick, not enough power on that. Hopefully it still works. Says no, it goes right to Hayford, and we've given them good field position. Although, to be honest, their offense is doing so well, I'm not sure field position matters a whole lot. All right, can we get the stop here? First down, it is going to be a draw. We do stop them. It's a loss of two. Wow, you just have to rush seven guys every play, and maybe you have a chance. Nine carries for 190 yards for Ted Lilly. That's absurd. I am absolutely baffled. Second and 12, they will go with the pass. It's a little screen. Mackey with a great shot. Third and long, maybe a chance to hold him to a field goal, but we'll be down two scores regardless. If I'm lucky, they'll go right back to another screen. Third and nine, maybe a slip screen. It's not a slip screen. They'll go short. Bad pass. They found the man, but it's fourth and six. So another field goal attempt for him. Absolutely expecting them to hit this one. They're 0 for 2, but it's just because of the distance. Although he has pushed it both times. A strong amount of wind today. This one's going to be... Wow, was that short as well? Are you telling me I could have tried to return that? Oh my gosh, this kicker is having a rough day so far. First and 10, we're going 5 wide. We'll see. Can we find somebody open? Let's go with the safe throw. We find Deion Fountain. There's a little bit of blocking and we get a quick 12 yards. We need to score fast here, I think. Let's go ahead and just continue to throw the ball as much as possible. And let's just give them the ball right back. Okay. Well, they have 6 turnovers in their first 2 games. So I guess their defense is pretty solid. This is frustrating, to say the least. Full tilt at this point. Engage 8 on first down. Try to stop this. It is a handoff up the middle. We only dropped him for a loss of 1, but it's better than giving up whatever his average is of like 20. The second down, they're going to go play action. All the time in the world as the quarterback tries to take off and does successfully. He breaks a tackle. He's got... What the hell is that blocking? He just ran... Oh my God. You've got to be kidding me. Nobody could disengage on the line. Charles Steele has his tackle broken. Mason Shelton just missed by a mile. And then look at the block on Diggs. Literally could not disengage. That is the easiest touchdown run this quarterback will ever have. I legitimately hate NC State. Like, there is no team I dislike more than these bastards. They do just such mean things to us. Who cares that Georgia beat South Carolina? Oh my goodness. I am livid right now. Everything about this game has just been made to anger me. Oh my gosh. We can't even get a good kick return on top of all that. No idea what to do at this point, except for just to hope for a miracle and I guess cheese the QB scramble. We don't get the blocking that they do, but we still, hey, finally got to 100 rushing yards. They got that in one play. Let's go play action here on this first down. We probably threw a pick last time we were in this area. Not going to throw a pick this time. We do find DJ Johnson, who, okay, got a little back juke, a little step back cheese, got to 21 yards. And I'm going to get greedy and try the flea flicker again. There's no way this works. They're bringing a blitz. Yeah, just not enough help from the offensive line to get a play like that off right now. So we're back to a second and 16 for what feels like the millionth time in this game. I literally see nobody that is good to throw to. Everything I'm worried is going to be a pick right now, so I'd rather have a third and 16. This might be the worst game I've played in a long time, especially with a team that's been doing pretty dang well so far this season. We'll try to throw. They're not going to bring too much pressure, but they are bringing some. And Tyson Mobley... can't get up there. 3 picks in the game, plus a fumble. If we win this game, it's an absolute miracle because literally the offense is worthless. 2.5 quarters in and our offense has 0 points in the game, but has given the other team a whole heap. 4 turnovers and they just continue to move. This is not an 88 overall team that we're playing. There is absolutely zero way that you could convince me that they are, because they are not playing anything like it. Diggs misses a tackle. They get another first down, unsurprisingly. I don't understand how we can rush 7 and 8 players every single play and still get burned as badly as we have been. Look at another play. Finally, we actually wrap up a quarterback. Believe it or not, a quarterback didn't break our tackle for once. And we drop him only for a loss of 3, though. They're going to come out and run for about 75 on the next play. Let's hope for the best. I don't have my fingers crossed, that's for sure. Look at that. Run. Broken tackle. Great blocking. It's not even their starter. going in gauge 8. In fact, I'm going in gauge 9. If they pass the ball, we lose. Oh, they went with a screen. Thank goodness. Thank freaking goodness we held them to a field goal. I mean, our chances of winning this are about 1 in a million, but it won't be as embarrassing. And you know what? This kicker has been atrocious the whole game, so we're going to send Marquise back to return it. Somehow he keeps shorting him. Maybe he can short this one as well. 46-yarder. He's finally going to sneak one through. Oh, he got lucky. I think the wind pulled it in for him. Minute and 33 left in the third. Down a bajillion. And it's going to take a miracle, especially when the offense has been worthless. Maybe our special teams can get it done. They need Marquise to return this one, but the blocking has been not good so far on these attempts. And again, it's really not that good. He managed to get to the 30 just out of sheer will, but nothing else doing there. All right. Well, Grayson is the worst passer in this game by a long shot, but we have to continue to pass because we don't have another option. We don't have enough time to be running the ball. I don't know what the problem was, but the game wouldn't let me run it in the hurry up, so hopefully the loss of time doesn't hurt us too badly. As will we go in the hurry up now? Yes. Just keep throwing here and hoping that something good happens, as I'm going to try to continue to scramble as much as possible. Although, I'm sure Grayson's about to fumble the ball and they're about to recover it. First and 10 now again, outside the pocket, over the top, we have Tyson Mobley. Good pass, good catch. Okay, could we score a touchdown? That would be the start. Touchdowns and onside kicks are how we're going to get back into this one. Okay, this must be a play that I made. Logan Mauldin definitely not running a route that looks correct, so we'll try to fix that with a little hot route, and Grayson breaking a tackle. I got to make sure he gets out of bounds because he's about to fumble the ball with how low his stamina is. Braden Bennett is in here on this second and 3, and we're going to give him the ball, and we're going to get inside the red zone. We need to score this touchdown before the fourth quarter starts, that's for sure. 21 seconds left. We'll see if Grayson can be accurate on this throw, as Deion Fountain can't hold on to it. That's a bit of a bummer. Second and 10 now. Going to the air again. Instead, we're actually going to scramble, and never mind, Grayson is so tired. I don't think we're going to be able to scramble for the rest of the game. It's 3rd and 8. And we will hopefully look to the air to try and pick this one up. There's Beasley. Dive. Get the end zone. That's all that matters. We finally scored a touchdown. It's going to be a 10-point game. We have the whole fourth quarter. If the defense steps up, maybe there's a chance. All right. Onside kick attempt number 2 of the game. That one looked like a pretty solid amount of power. And Hayford gets it. It's a great bounce, but unfortunately, he's got great hands and 2 seconds left in the third. NC State gets to start a drive with great field position. I think both sides know what's about to happen here. Expecting the run to Lilly. No, they go with a screen, and how does he get? He had no forward momentum, and he got that much stiff arm cheese to get 8 yards. This quarterback's still 12 of 12 as we head into the fourth quarter. I mean, we're getting jobbed right now. The game does not want me to win, is what it feels like. So we'll continue to try and bring the pressure, calling this a run to the left. It seems like it's going to be a run. It's a pass, and it's another first down. Eugene Thompson got it for 6 yards. Time to just start running in gauge 8. I think I know how to win this. We go if we can consistently start to score, if we let them score, but we go for 2-point conversion to onside kicks, we'll have a chance to get back into it. I don't see another way to win this. The insane thing to me is that we were in an engage 8 and they picked up 7 yards. We're in the same engage 8 and they're going to pick up a first down. Like, how bad can our defense be this game? They don't have a good offensive line. Makes absolutely no sense. The running back doesn't seem to get tired at all. I'm expecting maybe a screen. They go to the air. They go out in the flat. Okay, knocked him out of bounds. 2nd and 6. We have to hold them to a field goal or we're dead. Biggest problem there is that we haven't been able to hold them to much at all this game. Expecting a run on this one. It's going to be, oh my gosh, the quarterback. I don't know if that was a triple option or what, but we hit him in the backfield, 3rd and 10, and a chance to hold them here. Oh, please. Please, defense, do me a favor. What can we do? They went with a screen. Please get there, Stokes. You need to get the tackle. Thank goodness. Oh my gosh, we didn't give up a touchdown on the drive. We're still alive. Maybe they missed this. They haven't been great kicking. So on 4th and 10, Minute and a half gone in the fourth quarter. Kick is up, and it's good. But it's you know, a 13-point game now. This is possible. This would be a comeback for the ages. Definitely not getting the revenge that we wanted so far in this game. And I don't know what our coverage team has been doing on these returns, but Jackson is not gone, but he's across the 35. So close to turning the corner and being able to turn on the afterburners. Even still, he gives us great field position to work with. So it looks like they want to bring pressure, and I'm going to get McCall outside the pocket immediately. Not even a point to try and throw the ball there when we can run for 15 easily. I really want to run that flea flicker again, but I know for a fact it won't work, so there's no point in it. Instead, we'll try the play action on first down, and they are bringing pressure, so outside the pocket we go to throw it across to Aaron Bedgood, and you're moving the ball really well right now. Just keep doing the same thing, especially if they're bringing all this pressure. Oh, that was a bad throw. Thank goodness they hit the turf. Didn't mean to throw off the back foot. Maybe lucky. Probably would have been picked off. Our passing has been anything but good on the day, so any reason for us not to accidentally throw a pick is great news, as Jackson, that's a pass interference, got caught up by his man, but, you know, wasn't actually, he just got stuck, and the game's not going to call it. So on this 3rd and 10, now we'll continue to go to the air, hoping for the best, and it's a tough throw. Mobley came down with it, 4th and 1, we have to go for this. We're calling a pass play, I'm looking to run on this one, just got to hope for the best. As the edge is available to us, Grayson, not going to get there. Are you kidding me, dude? How can our blocking be so bad when theirs is so phenomenal? We can't disengage from a block to save our lives. They do it immediately. We lose yards and we lose the ball. That's game. There's no way, unless the defense gets incredibly lucky here. I've never seen so much bullcrap in my life. Like, just how impossibly good this NC State team has been. On top of that, they're burning clock as well, so it's really going to take a miracle. 2nd and 15, probably going to see another run, and it is a handoff, and well, we can't afford to take our timeouts, but it is 3rd down. All right, will they go to the air? Maybe a screen here? No, they're going to hand it off. Okay, still can't afford to take the timeout because we still need them, so we get the stop. We need a kick return here. If this punt isn't returned fantastically, we're in a lot of trouble. We're in a lot of trouble regardless. Down to 13. A very, very slim chance to come back and win. We know exactly when they are going to snap the ball, but I don't think it's worth trying to block it because blocking punts in this game is next to ridiculous or next to impossible. So 5 seconds left on the game clock. 4th and 9. They're going to have to punt this one away. Hoping for a returnable ball. Hoping for some good blocking as we try to get towards the corner. Oh my gosh, dude. They are just so fast on their special teams. So we're kind of back to where we were before our last turnover on downs. Only this time there's a lot less time on the clock. And this time we're taking a sack for a loss of 10 yards. This team can't do anything right. We literally, the only chance we have less than a minute to play now is just to cheese the four verts and hope that somebody does their job perfectly. And Baldwin kind of helping there, but we have 51 seconds. Down 2 scores. I just don't see how it happens. Gonna keep going. Outside the pocket. Nobody opens, so we can scramble and at least we'll be able to get out of bounds and stop the clock with 45 seconds to go. All right. What do we got on this 1st down? Again, outside the pocket. Mobley came down with that. Okay. So somehow held on through the contact. Broke a tackle. Couldn't get further, but stops the clock with a 1st and goal. And we'll see. Can we get into the end zone? 2nd time this game. That one's incomplete. Looking for DJ Johnson. This might be a pass interference finally. Okay. Well, we got some positive yards for free out of that one. Puts us at the 3-yard line. It's just a shame it's taken this long for the refs to decide that they care about calling this one fairly. As, again, I have to look towards the scramble. Back of the end zone, there's Deion Fountain. We score the touchdown, 6-point game. 30 seconds and all of our timeouts. Maybe a small chance. And we need a miracle here on this onside kick. We've gotten them before. Can we get this one? That wasn't a terrible kick. Oh my gosh, Hayford, literally the greatest hands I've ever seen, and with 31 seconds left, they basically can just run the clock out. We'll see. Can we manage to slow them down or force a fumble? Who knows? We'll be taking our timeouts. Oh my gosh, this guy, how did they get so lucky? They were able to burn a couple seconds just because he wouldn't go down. It's just so ridiculous. On this 2nd and 10, we get into the backfield. We get the stop. It's 3rd and 13. Oh my goodness. Could this be the stop that we need? Oh no. They're going to run the ball. I was kind of expecting them to pass. It's smart of them to run. 18 seconds left. It's 4th and 11. We're going to get the ball back. Hopefully they don't kick this field goal. So they'll punt it away, which means we'll basically get time for 2 plays. I don't think this will be returnable. I don't think it's wise to try to return it. And yeah, it's in the end zone, so we'll take the touchback. 13 seconds to go. 80 yards to go. I don't like our odds. It's four verts time as we will pray to the NCAA 14 gods. Deion Fountain can't come down with that, and it's basically all over now. 7 seconds to play. Gotta be honest, I kind of thought one of their players was a referee, so that's a little bit disappointing. There's Tyson Mobley, who catches it, and oh my gosh, I got him out of bounds. We get one more play to find the end zone here. It'll take a miracle. I'm not certain that Grayson can get it that far. I gotta hope that he can, as we'll wait, we'll throw. Oh my gosh, that ball is well short. Bounces around a ton, hits the ground. Game's over, we lose by 6. That was the worst. That was so, so frustrating. I mean, to spend the entire first quarter driving down to the inch line to then give them the ball, not be able to convert, and then for them to immediately run for a 99-yard touchdown carry, and then to throw 3 interceptions and have a fumble. Like, that is... Oh, about as bad as it could get. This game shouldn't have been close. We should have been able to blow them out, but we couldn't hold on to the football. On top of all the turnovers, yeah, 2 turnovers on downs. So we just gave them the ball basically for free 6 times in that game. And you're not going to win when you do that. So tried to give it a shot at the end. Just didn't have enough time. And it's a disappointing loss. We're going to lose our ranking. It's going to hurt us with recruits. That was about as disastrous as it could get. So really, really disappointed there. We gave up 249 rushing yards. Oh my gosh. 4 turnovers. Like, you can't win with those two. Ted Lilly, 13 carries for 200 yards. That's just stupid. It's so broken. Aaron Diggs with a sack and a forced fumble, but we can't recover because we don't get turnovers in our favor. Grayson with 3 interceptions. Just bad game. Don't want to talk about it. Want to move on. As always, you know, we get our ranking and then immediately lose it. That's just tradition for us. So we'll move to the week against Baylor and hope that that doesn't hurt us too much with the recruits. Because this season, I think it's dead in my eyes. Not going undefeated. It's going to take a long shot to make the playoff now. Well, again, always trying to find a silver lining. We do have 3 recruits, 3 very good recruits ready to visit. We got 3 sacks in the game. Woohoo! We're unranked. Baylor's 0-1. They're the better team. Somehow we're favored to win. Already -5 in the turnover differential. 3 games into the season is so brutal. NC State jumps up to number 8 in the country, which I think means we saw some other teams lose. Let's see. Washington loses to USC. Stanford loses to Colorado. This could be good for us, I guess. Maybe the conference prestige is higher, as Auburn lost to Mississippi State, LSU lost to Vanderbilt. Only us and South Carolina dropped out of the rankings, but South Carolina losing is good for us as well. We're not receiving votes anymore, as you know, nor should we, but you know, things could be okay, things could be worse. I got to imagine that that NC State running back is in the Heisman watch after that one. No love for him. He deserves it. Dude put on a clinic against us. Unfortunately, that's gonna have to do it for this episode. Such a disappointing loss. We can't win them all, obviously, but you know, I'm so frustrated at the way that the game started, and then it seemed like a downward spiral until we finally found the end zone in what, the end of the third quarter. Like, it took us so long to score offensive points that it was just too late. If you want to see the, you know, the bounce back, though, please feel free to subscribe if you haven't already. It's free to do, and it helps the channel grow, which means the world to me, and thank you guys for the support. And then, you know, while you're down there, hit like, hit and subscribe. Go to the description where you can find links to my Twitch at twitch.tv/goonmaster, as well as links to my Twitter and our community Discord. That being said, thank you guys again so much for watching. We'll try to get them next time as we go on the road to Baylor. But my name is Goonmaster. You guys are the Teal Boys. And wherever you are, have a good night or have a good morning. And we'll see you later. Adios.